Hello foodies and welcome to another episode of Recipes You Like. Today in this video, as you know, we are making chocolate chips, but not with the usually used compound chocolate as it's not easily available in the market, but we'll be making with the basic cocoa powder. If you like the recipe, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and give your valuable feedback and comments in the comment section below. So without any delay, let's begin. Don't forget to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates from recipes you like. To start with, let's take 1 cup of powdered sugar or caster sugar. Make sure that the sugar is ground in a fine powder so that there are no lumps. Now we will also sieve 1 cup of cocoa powder. Clean your sieve before sieving the cocoa powder for the smooth flow of cocoa powder. We have used here unsweetened Cadbury's cocoa powder. It's easily available in the grocery stores. Blend or mix both of these nicely together. Now get hold of a soft plastic bag. We have taken here a milk polythene bag and we will make a cone out of it in the way as shown, and then place it over the glass. Take 1 cup of vegetable oil, it's even called dalda or shortening. Melt it down. As soon as the vegetable oil melts down, make sure that it's warm but not hot, and then add the bowl of mixed dry ingredients. Putting off the stove flame. Incorporate everything nicely. Don't over mix it. As soon as you are sure that everything has blended well, stop mixing and pour it. Secure it with a rubber band or a clip, and then to convert into a cone, cut a small tip of the bag and start dropping the chocolate mix in form of drops. We have used plastic sheet over here. You can do it over a butter paper or even the aluminium foil. If you feel that your chocolate mix is too runny or your chocolate chips are becoming flat, then wait for a couple of minutes. Let this chocolate mix get a little bit cold and thick, and then again start making the chocolate chips. And remember, don't give too much of pressure to squeeze out the chocolate. Now at this point, after making so many chocolate chips, our chocolate batter has become a little bit thick. It's getting difficult to drop it. Here, using the double boiler method, we will melt this chocolate again. Let's remove out from the cone chocolate as much as possible. And then take some water in a vessel. Keep the chocolate filled pan over it, making sure that it's not touching the water beneath. As soon as the water starts boiling, you must remove the chocolate above the boiling water and put off the heat. Start piping it again, repeating the same procedure as shown before. Here we are using the back side of an Ashirwad Atta packet wrapped over a tray. Keep these trays into the refrigerator minimum for an hour. So after taking out from the fridge, our chocolate chips are ready. We have also made it over a greased plate. It doesn't seem to be too easy to pull out from the plate, but dropped on the plastic wrapper, they come out easily. Keep the chocolate chips stored in an airtight container into a refrigerator. And use them whenever you want for making various recipes. See you in another episode with another interesting recipe. Till then, keep healthy and enjoy cooking.